Ebola virus was discovered in 1976 after two deadly outbreaks in Central Africa. Since then, Ebola viruses have emerged periodically in this and other regions of the continent. In 2014, a large outbreak of Ebola struck Guinea, Liberia, and neighboring countries in West Africa, killing thousands of people and threatening to destabilize these developing nations.
We're in the middle of a cataclysmic outbreak in West Africa.
Dr. Anthony Fauci is the director of the National Institute of Allergy and Infectious Diseases, or NIAID, where scientists are spearheading efforts to develop Ebola vaccines and treatments as quickly as possible.
As this epidemic now has become most extraordinary in its historic scope, it is entirely conceivable that despite the infusion of resources for classical infection control with identification, isolation, contact tracing, we may actually need a safe and effective vaccine to actually end this epidemic in West Africa.
Several Ebola vaccine candidates are undergoing testing in people after proving to be effective in animals. One of these products is an experimental vaccine developed by researchers at NIAID's Vaccine Research Center. It uses a chimpanzee cold virus to deliver a small piece of Ebola genetic material to the body. Dr. Nancy Sullivan is one of the researchers developing the vaccine.
That piece of Ebola virus mimics the protein that's on the outside of the virus. So when the vaccine is given, it fools the person's immune system into thinking that it's infected, but in fact, it's not infected. The vaccine is not made out of virus. It just contains a very small piece of the virus.
NIAID has partnered with pharmaceutical company GlaxoSmithKline to advance the vaccine through clinical trials, beginning with phase 1 safety testing at the National Institutes of Health and expanding to additional sites in the United States and abroad. Researchers hope to advance the vaccine through all three phases of clinical testing to ensure that it is both safe and effective in preventing Ebola infection. NIAID will continue to work with industry and government partners to accelerate efforts to develop Ebola vaccines and treatments in a way that is both scientifically and ethically sound.
When you have a trial of a vaccine, the first thing you show in phase one is safety. If it's safe, then you want to show that it induces the kind of response that you would predict would be protective. Once you establish that initial safety, then you go into a much larger trial that defines the efficacy. Does it really work under conditions of the disease outbreak? So it's a multi-step process that's tried and true and has proven to be effective historically with many vaccines.